66-year-old Liore Benedicto Pasco has spent the past 3 years demanding justice for his two sons. Crisanto and Juan Carlos Lozano were killed in a police operation in Quezon City in May 2017. Police described them as robbers who fought back against law enforcers. Two guns were recovered from the siblings, but their mother is not convinced.
Nakita nila doon, yung anak kong nakahawak ng .38, kaliwete yun, pero nasa kanan yung baril.
Pasco believes the two were killed after they volunteered their names in the village drug list. They were drug users, she says, but they have been clean since then.
Encourage ko sila na talagang pumunta kayo, total, wala, malinis naman na ang mga record nyo. Nakakagalit talaga na hindi talaga, wala talagang nag-akala na yung pagpapalista pala na yun ay magiging mitsa ng buhay nila.
The recent news about the ICC prosecutor's findings that there is reasonable basis to believe that crimes against humanity took place in the Philippines between July 2016 when Duterte took office and March 2019 when the Philippines pulled out of the ICC has brought a renewed sense of hope for the likes of Pasco. For legal experts, ICC prosecutor Fatou Bensouda's report is a significant development as it means the probe will move forward.
It's like saying there's probable cause for a crime against humanity here in the Philippines. That's why we can go now to the next phase, which is preliminary investigation.
Mayroon na po silang datingnan at tinitingnan ng mga grupo ng kaso na nakita talaga silang maaring imbestigan ng ICC.
The ICC prosecutor hopes to come up with a decision within the next 6 months as to whether there is enough basis to proceed to the preliminary investigation stage to probe the drug war killings in the country and see if Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte can be held responsible for the crimes. But this early, Malacanang dismissed the report. The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency complains the ICC prosecutor's report was unfair, unjustifiable, and one-sided. They expressed skepticism as to how the ICC could come up with findings based on open-source information. But for grieving mothers like Pasco, the ICC prosecutor's statement is a huge boost to their continued fight for justice. Aside from actively lobbying for the international community to look into the human rights situation in the Philippines, Pasco and her group Rise Up, along with Manila-based Karapatan and National Union of People's Lawyers, will take part in an independent international probe spearheaded by lawyers and faith-based groups from the United States, Canada, and Australia. It was launched online on Thursday, dubbed Investigate PH. It hopes to submit its findings to the UN Human Rights Council, the UN General Assembly, and the International Criminal Court by next year.
Hinahangad talaga namin na magkaroon ng investigasyon at panagutin. Ikulong siya at panagutin sa lahat ng mga ginawa niyang pagkakasala.
Duterte, for his part, says he is not afraid to go to jail. In his speech Wednesday night, he lashed at former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV, who said Tuesday, the president must be quivering in fear of the ICC.
Kung hindi ka ba talaga ugaling aso, ako magpakamatay ako sa prinsipyo ko. Kung ikamatay ko, ba okay yan sa akin? Ipakulong ako habang may okay sa akin yan. Pero ginawa ko ang tiyak ko na tama.
In response, Trillanes says the president's happy days would soon be over. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.